Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is the Chief IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily current affairs based MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss 10 MCQs based upon the current affairs of the day. So today is 12th September, so let's see what are the questions for the day. So the first question is, consider the following statements related to market intervention scheme. First, the scheme is applicable only to the horticultural crops. Second, the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation is implementing the scheme. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that the correct answer is B, that is second only. So the Department of Agriculture Cooperation and Agriculture and Cooperation is implementing it. So government is planning basically to procure almost 12 lakh metric tons of apple this season under this market intervention price scheme. So it is a price support mechanism implemented on the request of state governments. So it is for the procurement of perishable as well as horticulture commodities. So implemented when there is at least 10% increase in production or at least 10% decrease in ruling rates over the previous normal year. So it is not operative normally, but when the production increases by 10% or there is 10% reduction in the rates, then only it is implemented. So the objective is to basically protect the growers of the horticulture agricultural commodities from making distress sale. So Department of Agriculture and Cooperation is implementing the scheme. So funding is basically, funds are not allocated to the states. Instead, central share of losses as per the guidelines of this is released to the state government UT, for which MIP has been approved based on specific proposals received from them. So area of operation is restricted to the concerned state only. So it has been implemented in case of commodities like apples, kinu, malta, garlic, oranges, galgal, grapes, mushroom, clove, black pepper, pineapple, ginger, red chilies, coriander seed extra. So the question is based upon the news from the Hindu. And next is second question. Second is, consider the following pairs of ports and their respective nations. First is Shahbar Port, Iran. Second is Gwadar Port, Pakistan. Third, Colombo Port, Sri Lanka. Fourth, Port of Dukam, you may pronounce it in any way. So, Oman. So, we have to choose that which of the above pairs is correctly matched. Let me tell you, friends, that it is very easy question. Yes, Shahbar Port is in Iran. We are developing this Shahbar Port in Iran, and Gwadar Port is in basically Pakistan. Colombo Port is in Sri Lanka, and your Port of Dukam is in Oman. So all of these statements are correct. So the solution is D. So question is again based upon a news that was there in the Hindu. Next is third question. Third is South Asia's first cross-border petroleum pipeline is established between which two nations? So please note this South Asia word. So first cross-border petroleum pipeline is being established. So it is being established in India and Nepal. So the solution is B. So this petroleum pipeline is from Motihari and Amalekhganj petroleum pipeline will transport fuel from Baroni refinery in Bihar's Begusarai district to Amalekhganj in southeastern Nepal, situated across the border from Raksal in East Champaran district. So it is a 69 km pipeline, will drastically reduce the cost of transporting fuel to landlocked Nepal from India. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Jallianwala Bagh massacre. First, Edward Montagu was the Secretary General at the time of this incident. Second, Rabindranath Tagore renounced his knighthood in the protest against this incident. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that yes, first statement is also correct. Edward Montagu was the basically Secretary General at that time, and Rabindranath Tagore renounced his knighthood in the protest against this incident. So which of the above statements is correct? Both of these statements are correct. So the solution is C, and the answer basically reference you can check in India Struggle for Independence by Bipin Chandra, and then sources from the Hindu News. Fifth is, consider the following statements related to Asian Development Bank. First, it is headquartered in Tokyo, Japan. Second, Japan is the largest shareholder in this bank, followed by USA. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that first statement is clearly incorrect, but second is correct. Yes, Japan is the largest shareholder, a shareholder in this bank, followed by USA. So it is basically based in Philippines, Manila. So it is for the social and economic development in Asia. So it was established in 1966. It is a regional development bank, and it has 67 members, of which 84 to 48 are from within Asia and Pacific, and 19 from outside. So Japan holds the largest proportion of shares in Asian Development Bank, followed by USA. Next is, consider the following statements. First, India is a member of International Labour Organization. Second is, India has ratified the Occupational Safety and Health Convention recently. So we have to choose that which of the above statement is correct. So friends, only first statement is correct. Yes, India is a member of International Labour Organization. So it was basically created in 1919. So it is a United Nations agency which deals with labor issues, particularly international labor standards, social protection, and work opportunities for all. It was created as part of Treaty of Versailles that ended the World War I, and to reflect the belief that universal and lasting peace can be accomplished only if it is based on social justice. So it became specialized agency of UN in 1946. So it is a tripartite organization, only of its kind, bringing together representatives of governments, employers, and workers in its executive bodies. So please note this is very important. So it is a tripartite organization, including governments and employers as well as employees. So since 1919, this International Labour Organization has maintained and developed a system of international labour standards aimed at promoting opportunity for women and men to obtain decent and productive working conditions in conditions of freedom, equity, security, and dignity. So in 1969, it received Nobel Peace Prize for improving fraternity and peace among nations, pursuing decent work and justice for workers, and providing technical assistance to other developing nations. So India is a founder member of the International Labour Organization. So headquarters is basically in Geneva, Switzerland. So please note that India is a founding member. So India is not just it has not joined it recently. So it is a founding member. Next is 7. Which of the following city has the highest number of startups in India? A. Bengaluru, B. Mumbai, C. Noida, D. None of the above. So friends, this was a news based upon this is a question based upon the news that was there in yesterday's newspaper. So the answer is A, that is Bengaluru. So Bengaluru has highest number of startups in India. So source is basically The Hindu. Next is, consider the following statements related to Basel Convention. First, it is an international treaty to reduce the movement of hazardous waste between nations. Second, it does not address the movement of radioactive waste materials. Which of the above statements is correct, friends? Both of these statements are incorrect. So answer is, solution is C. So it is basically an international treaty that reduces the movement of hazardous waste between nations. So it does not, however, address the movement of radioactive waste materials. So 1995 Basel ban amendment, it was a basically global waste dumping prohibition, has become an international law after Croatia ratified it on September 6th, 2019. So it is the 97th country to ratify it. So what is next? It will become a new article in the convention, and will enter into force in the 97 countries after 19 days on December 5th. So about it is that Basel ban amendment, it is adopted by the parties to the Basel convention in 1995 to address the to protect human health and environment against this adverse effects of the hazardous waste. So amendment prohibits all exports of hazardous wastes, including electronic wastes and obsolete ships, from 29 wealthiest countries of Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development to non-OECD countries. So Basel convention, it is basically control of transboundary movement of hazardous waste and their disposal. So these are more details about it. So sources basically from your down to earth. And next is, consider the following statements related to snow leopard. First, it is listed as vulnerable on the IUCN red list. Second, it is endemic to India, and the habitat is located in the Himalayan states. So which of the above statements is correct? We have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that yes, first is correct. This is listed vulnerable on the IUCN red list. And this is basically this conservation of snow leopards and preservation of people's cultural values. It is said that preservation of people's cultural value can prevent land degradation of Himalayan ecosystems. That exports at ongoing 14th conference of parties of the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. So snow leopard is the apex predator in the region. Saving it will mean that we will need to save the prey base of herbivores too, and to save the prey base will mean preserving the grassland they feed on. So desertification is happening. Why? Because there is an increasingly focus upon conversion of land into for agricultural purposes, as well as for land is being degraded by deforestation. So snow leopard conservation will ensure that herbivores will have to be saved, and herbivores can feed only on grassland, so grassland will have to be preserved. So in this way land degradation can be prevented. So it is listed as vulnerable of the on the IUCN red list. So it inhabits alpine and subalpine elevations. So state animal, it is a state animal of Uttarakhand and national heritage animal of Pakistan. So it is not just endemic to India, please note it. So its habitat extends through 12 countries, which are given here. So it is also listed in Appendix 1 of the Convention on International Trade of Endangered Species. So Snow Leopard Forum 2013, basically it comprises 12 countries encompassing the snow leopard range. So Biscayne Declaration is to basically protect the species and its environment. So Global Snow Leopard and Ecosystem Protection Program is there. Joint initiative of range countries is there, and the international agency, civil society and private sector which aim to secure the long-term survival of the snow leopard in its natural ecosystem. So next is consider the following statements. First is governor of the state is appointed by the president under the article 155 of the Indian Constitution. Second, the governor is the head of the state. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So the answer would be C, that is both 1 and 2. So reference is there in Indian Polity by Lakshmikant. So you can check the standard book for more explanation. So friends, this is all about today's discussion about current affair MCQ. So if you like the video, if you like the discussion, if you like the questions, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, if in case you want to remain in touch with the updates that we do on our channel and the initiatives we launch for the purpose of civil service aspirants, then you can join our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen and will also be provided in the description box. So using this link you can join our you can join our Telegram channel so that you can remain in touch with the with our updates. And also if you have any doubts, if you have any queries, you can mail us at archiveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 89689-20720. You can also ask your queries in the comment box. And lastly friends, if in case you are willing to join for the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can contact us here or you can check the description box where the link will be provided for the subscription of these PDFs. Obviously friends, we have kept a minimum subscription fee for the PDF, that is ₹99 per month, and that is just for the purpose of our motivation, so that we people can remain motivated to help you people. So if in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you join it. So if in case you think that someone else can get benefit also, then you can also share with that this video with other students as well. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead. Thank you very much.